I was sitting here thinking about when I didn't have money, when I used to be broke, the struggles, the trials, the tribulations that I went through when I was that person. And I got a little depressed because that's not something fun to think about. That's not good times. That is pretty much the worst period in my life, because one of the things that I knew that I wanted to be successful, I wanted to be a person of note. I wanted to be a remarkable person. I wanted to be accomplished. And I was so frustrated because I was looking for all of these answers in these strange places and I wasn't finding any answers. You know, this was before the internet, and we used to read magazines, and there was this Entrepreneur, How to Make Money. There was these magazines that were the precursors to hustler porn. And I would order these courses out of the bag of these magazines, and it was, you know, very well structured, but it didn't teach me anything about business. It didn't teach me anything about sales. It didn't teach me anything about marketing. It didn't teach me nothing. And I remember that I really, really focused on money. I was so determined. I wrote down my goal that I wanted to make $10 million. Wrote it on a sheet of paper, right? That didn't happen. It just never happened because I wrote these goals down. And here's the problem, and I want to share this with you because I feel that many of you are making the same mistake. You are looking at where you are and you're looking at where you want to go, and you're focusing on where you want to go, but there is no thought, consideration, or anything of the vehicle. That is the missing ingredient in your quest, in your hunt. There is no economic vehicle. There is on this side, this is where I'm at. Over here, this is where I want to go. And all this in the middle is non-existent. There's no thought, there's no consideration, because you don't know what you don't know. You don't understand that you don't know a lot of this stuff. You don't understand that much of this stuff isn't taught, because you're just like, you're a smart person. You have these desires, you have these cravings, you want these things in life. You're just kind of going with what seems logical. If I want money, I should focus on money. And I'm here to tell you that is the wrong area to focus in. You should not be focusing on money. At the beginning of this year, I asked myself a series of questions. How can I serve my customer base? How can I serve my audience? If you notice that I'm not selling anything from Hustlers Kung Fu Life Skills anymore, I don't recommend, I don't put it, I didn't even really do any Black Friday sales. When I was asking myself, what could I do to serve people, this agenda came up of the corporate citizen. And it came up because of my lifestyle. It came up because there needs to be more people where I am. I asked myself a question, how did I get here? And this is really interesting because it all started with me being in that boarding house. It started with me taking action. I started taking action in that boarding house with Scheme Incorporated, which is how I got the job at Rent-A-Crate. And I have not stopped taking action since. And this is the thing that's going to get you. First of all, you must identify some kind of vehicle, because there are people who are getting rich with car washes. There are people who are getting rich making dog food. You know, many of you ask me, what kind of business should I get into? And this is the question that you really have, but you're not asking. What is the least path of resistance between me being here and how I can get here? That is the wrong attitude. That is the wrong perspective to have, because you're looking for an easy, direct line. You're like, I'm here and I want to go here. And you're looking for a direct, straight line, no fluff, no pain, no agitation, just go here. I'm now the man. I was here, now I'm the man. Essentially, it don't work like that. It doesn't work like this. And this is one of the reasons I'm doing this video, to inform you that you must be about service. You must have a service, a product, a thing, or something that helps people, make them better, make them laugh, whatever. You can get rich telling jokes. There's comedians who are multimillionaires. There are actors. There are singers. There are people who make purses. There are people who make shoes. You must serve your fellow man to go from the bottom to the top. Now, there are many advertisements here on YouTube that are pretty much tantamount to scam. And they're preying upon your emotional cues. They know that you're weary. They know that you're tired. They know that you want to move to the next level. They know that you need money. And this is embedded in their copywriting, get you the design to click and buy on their products, like I did years ago when I was buying all of these courses and stuff out of the back of these magazines. And none of them got me any further than I was before I ordered them. And this is where I think that many of these online courses are going to get you no further than where you are, because they're not telling you the truth. Because I look at my journey. I look at being in that room in that boarding house. No heat, no air conditioning. I remember I had to go out and buy some extra blankets because when it got really cold, that was my heat. It was bad. It was really, really bad. And I was like, how did I get from there to here? And the answer is two things: making a decision, taking action. And I know many of you are really primed to take action, but you're incapacitated because you don't know what to take action on. Let me tell you what's holding you back. Fear of failure, fear of disaster, fear of bad outcome. This fear keeps you in suspended animation where you're actually doing nothing. You know that you need to be active. You know you need to make some decisions, but because you are afraid that if you're gonna try, and it's not gonna work out, it's gonna fail. And I'm here to tell you, you're right, because you don't know what you're doing. See, this is the beauty of taking massive action. When you try something and it doesn't work out, you learn something that you didn't know. And I cannot overstate how important that space is. When you take action and you get a result, you learn something new. And then what you do is take this new information that you now learned and apply it to your another action point. And then you learn something else. People love to ask me this question: what are your failures? My failures are not going to help you do a damn thing. I'm like, what are your failures? What did you try to do and it didn't work out? So let's talk about that. Let's go ahead and talk about where this comes from. Because when I was on a quest for leveling up, I didn't really care about anyone's failure. I wanted to know what they did to be successful. And many of you want to feel good to see someone successful, because like whenever I make a mistake or have a typo, there are people, you made a mistake. Gotcha. Really? I have on my corporate toolbox, a program that's about to make $1 million. I have all kinds of mistakes in that. They stop me from making that money. What can we learn from this? It doesn't have to be perfect. Here's the thing, and this is one of the things that's holding so many of you back. You're trying to create something perfect. You're trying to build something that's going to be immaculate when it doesn't. My first book, it was an editorial nightmare. It was a disaster. I had to put that book out 3 times. But what happened? I heard people, what they were saying, and that it was true. So I had to address it, but I kept taking action. I kept promoting the book. I kept putting the book out. I just kept going forward, regardless of how bad, someone left a really nasty review. And I was like, it's true, deal with it. And I just kept going. I kept taking action. And then I found this college student who edited my book and did a great job. And that version of the book is on Amazon to this day. I learned so much, but during that time when the book was an editorial nightmare, I made $62,000 my first year with that poorly edited book. Then the next year I made $92,000 with that poorly edited book. Let's go ahead and have this conversation. There are many of you who want to be successful, but you have a vision of success in your mind. And not only do you have a vision, you have a pathway. If I'm gonna get successful, I gotta do it this way. It must be dress right. All my I's and my T's must be crossed. And your vision of what being successful is not what it takes to be successful. Like someone put on here that, as rich as you are, I figure, one Airbnb, you need 50. So many of you have fantasies of being rich that you don't even know how rich folks get down because you don't know any. To quote Kevin Samuels. You don't know where the high value men are. You ain't around any high value men. You don't even have any friends. You don't know any, you don't know what to watch. Many of you have these assumptions of what wealthy people do and how wealthy people live. And I'm here to tell you, when Jeff Bezos became a billionaire, you know what he did the next day? He went into the office and he went to work. This is the thing that so many of you just don't get, that once you get to a certain level of money, it's going to be parties, fruit punch, cake. No. See, everyone who is rich, who got there through work, understands that they have to keep working to stay rich. I mean, you may get to a point where you can just kick back and just chill. This happens. But it ain't gonna happen in your first year. It's not gonna happen your second year, and it's not gonna happen your third year. This is one of the things that I want to describe to you, is you guys have got to make some decisions, and you have to commit to something. Because I get question after question, like, what should I do? What should I do? And you're in that suspended animation period where you're not doing anything. You're not taking any action. You're not creating anything. You're not doing anything. With that, your life is going to remain the same, because you're going to be in that same space, doing that same thing, living that same life, doing the same things over and over again, yielding no results. So what got me from that boarding house to this $1 million house is me making a decision, taking action, and not stopping taking action. Let that go. Stop wanting to sit down before you even got up. This kills me. You know, I'm gonna be frustrated. I put out amazing videos on Savage Finance, and a lot of y'all don't pay any attention because you're looking for easy, no check credit. You're looking for something that you can do simple, something that doesn't require you to change. To become successful, you gotta be something other than you are now. Because if what you were now was enough to get you to where you wanted to be, you would be there. And since you're not there, what you are at this moment ain't good enough. I know that's harsh. I know that a lot of people are all up in their feelings at that statement. But the reality is, you gotta change who you are, and you have to change your behavior to get where you want to be. So hopefully this message reaches you in good health, and we're about to start a new year. And hopefully you're gonna be making a decision, and hopefully you will be taking action. So for those of you who want to take action, go ahead and enroll in the Corporate Toolbox, where I'm going to teach you how to set up a holding company. I'm going to teach you operating companies. I'm going to teach you how to establish business credit. And I'm going to teach you how to start a company from nothing. And I'm going to teach you how to make it tax efficient. Links below, and there's a payment plan. So with that, I will see you guys in the next video.